Good day guys, this is the part 2 of our series in Kotlin Programming. So in this video we will talk about the basic types and variables in Kotlin. So let's go back here in our previous code. So we have the first print in our Kotlin program. So let's start. So in Kotlin, there are two types of variable declarations. It has var, which is a mutable type, and val, which is a immutable type. So var means that you can change the value of it after you initially set. So for example, let's declare a variable var name, and let's set it as a string, and let's add a initial value on it. So here I have a variable name with a type of string. So since var is a mutable, you can change it later, so like this. So let's say you want to change the initial value from John Wick to Johannes Wickensen. Since this is a var, this is a valid statement. Now we can print now the output. So let's run. Okay, so here's our output. So we just printed the name. Now how about the val? So when we declare a val, let's say now val job as a string equals to assassin. Okay. So since it is immutable, you cannot change it. So it's like a final declaration in Java. So when you declare a final, it is a constant. And when we say constant, whatever initial value you set, this will be the default value for the entirety of its program. You cannot change it. So let's say you want to change it to another value, let's say husband. You can see that there are some red squiggle beneath it, which signifies that the val cannot be reassigned. So this can cause an error. So if you are going to declare a variable that there is a possibility that it will change, you need to declare it as a var. So this one, so it remains assassin and not a husband. Okay, so you cannot compile it. It will cause an error. Okay, so we have an error here. And also, you can easily see that there's a problem because IntelliJ will warn you. So as you can see, there's a lot of squiggles here. We have squiggles for the type string. We have the squiggles for the string itself. So these are just warning, but you can follow it. Like for example, in Kotlin, we have a what we call type inference. So type inference means that the Kotlin can differentiate what kind of types you are assigning to a particular variable based on its value. So here, for example, the name, since we are assigning it a string which delimited by a double quote here and here, so it means that the type string is not necessary anymore, so you can delete it like that. It says that the initializer is redundant because we have assign it here. It means that this value could not be used in any way in our program right now. So we can change it here like this. Okay. So here is our. This is the var and the val. Okay. So our next is we have different data types in Kotlin. Basically, we have string, which we have just seen, and we have the numbers, which is integer, long, short, double, and float. So to declare a number, let's say var age integer is equals to 0. Or sorry, it's just int. So let's try different variables. Name, string, John Wick. Let's say grade is 98.7. Let's say this is double. Okay. And we have float. So when you're using float, you need to precede the value with letter F to signify that it is float, because by default if you written the value as is, like this one, 98.7, the compiler will treat it as a double by default. Okay, so we have integer, string, double, and float. The long and the short is the same as type int, but it has a, the long has a much larger size compared to int. It's twice as large as the int, and the short is twice as short as the int. So we can do some computations here. So let's say bar, let's say hourly pay is equals to, let's say 90. Let's say hours work is equals to 78. Then gross pay is equals to hourly pay times hours work. Then we can print the gross pay. Sorry, it's hours work. Okay, so here is our output. So 90 times 78. So next, so we have the type. Let's put it in a real example with the input and output from the user. So let's say you want to create a grade computation. So whenever we need an input, we need to use, or we need to import a particular class to do the input value. So you can import here. So import java.util.scanner. So this scanner class is being used in Java for input, but we can import it in our Kotlin because they are interoperable. Want to compute the grade of a particular student. So first let's prompt the user. So let's say enter student name. So var name is equals to, okay, if you are using string, readline function is sufficient to receive the input. But if you are receiving input that you need to treat as a number, we need to use the scanner. So let's declare a scanner object here. So input equals to scanner system.in. Let's say enter your prelim grade. So var prelim grade equals to input that next double. Enter your midterm grade. So let's add some separator here. So var midterm grade is equals to input next double. And lastly, the final grade. So enter your final grade. So var final grade is equals to input that next double. And then let's compute the average. So let's say average grade is equals to, let's add first the prelim, then the midterm, and the finals, then divide it by 3, and then let's output student name. Okay. Now, how are we going to append the name in our output? Usually, you can use the concatenation using the plus sign, like in plain old Java. But in Kotlin, you can use the string interpolation. So let's add some comment here. So what does it mean? It means that you can include the string or the variable directly in the string, but you need to precede it with a dollar sign like this, and then the variable. So here, so inside the string, you can see that we have the variable name. So there's a color coded, so you can easily see that this is a variable preceded by a dollar sign. So the same with for the average grade. So let's say grade is average grade. So let's run the program. Okay, so here in our output, so enter John, enter student name, let's say John Wick, prelim grade 89.90, 78.56, 95.70. Okay, student name John Wick, the grade is 88.05334. So here, this is our program. So here is the basic types in Kotlin and how to use them, and how to receive input and output from the command line in Kotlin. Then we can copy it and use and expand it in your example so that you can learn it properly. You can change it whatever you want and make some errors. If you have encountered any problem, just message me in the comment section and I will answer promptly. Okay, so that's it for now. We will explore more about it in our next videos. So don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date on these tutorials. Thank you guys.